was scheduled. So we'll see you this weekend. That's it.
Cool. Bye, Sarah.
Bye, guys.
Hey, Phil, you doing anything Sunday night?
Let me see.
Looks like I'm all free.
Cool. I've been really into cooking. You want to come to my place for a dinner party?
Oh, gee, yeah, sure. Should I bring anything?
No, just yourself, fresh and clean.
Yeah, sure, okay.
Yeah, just come fresh and clean.
Oh, okay. You got it, Brad guy.
Cool. Flesh and clean.
No.
Flesh and clean.
No.
Flesh and clean. Flesh and clean. Flesh and clean.
Stop it. No.
Flesh and clean.
I don't want to be sauteed. Your hand.
Just a wee little accident.
What? Alex, what are you talking about? Are you okay?
Yeah. I mean, I just have 9 fingers now.
What? Where? Alex, how are you not concerned at all? You're freaking me out.
What? Yeah, it was a good time overall. Played charades, sip Bloody Marys. You should have been there.
Alex, where?
Brian's. Take a chill pill, Phil.
Alex, what happened?
I'll tell you later. Pinky promise? Pinky promise. I'm still getting used to the new me. Bye, Philip.
Run. Run away as far as you can and don't look back, not even once.
Heads I go in, tails I don't.
Phil, how's it going? You look so tasty. Oh, wow, is that a designer shirt?
Yeah. Stop and Shop, actually.
Oh, really? What, aisle 3?
Yes, aisle 3, right next to all the bread.
Very nice, very nice. You look tasty. Come on then.
Thanks, Brian. Hey, what are those?
Alex left those. Pigs in a blanket. Can never seem to get enough ketchup.
Yeah. You got a little one. Never mind. Where's everybody else?
Oh, it's just us, silly.
Oh, fun.
Yeah.
So what are we making?
Oh, we're making Phil a mignon. Yeah. sorry. Just getting over a weak cold, you know.
Yum, I love filet mignon.
Yeah, if you want to look, I wrote the recipe down over here.
Freeze, police!
Is that what it looks like?
That's what they all say. Matthew McConaughey. Yeah. He has a movie. This past week, Republicans and the American Health Care Act took a big loss. It's reported that some hiker snapped a photo of the American Health Care Act walking around in the woods in Westchester County. Take a look. So, spring cleaning is here, and a study came out that vodka can be used as a cleaning agent. To which I say, let's start with my childhood. It's okay. Last week, I learned some languages to prepare to go to space, and this weekend I decided that it was time for me to get into the physical aspect of it. So I really, really took it hard, started to train, and Spaceway has this kind of philosophy that they think that they should really build up the self-esteem of, you know, their astronauts and their coworkers. So this is what I did this week. Some good protein. Yeah, so I think space SpaceWise going to start using that, and they were like, recruitment videos now? It's going to be great. So we've got a really exciting show for you tonight. Horror show. The BA main stage is here tonight to talk about their show. Hannah Thompson is our musical guest. And we'll be right back. Yeah. On an all-expense-paid vacation to Tokyo, Japan, because we can afford to do that. Now, to tell us all about her visit, please welcome Alex Bramer. So Alex, how was Japan? Alex? We can't do a show if you aren't going to talk.
Hi.
What? They're gone. We can talk now.
Alex, what's going on? Who are those guys?
Well, don't freak out, but there's a really strong possibility that I might be a Yakuza drug kingpin.
What?
I had quite the trip. Fun was had. Mistakes were made.
Okay, you're gonna have to do better than that. What did you say to those guys?
Oh, I just told them to get me some coke.
Okay. Since when do you speak Japanese?
Oh, I don't. I only say three things. Yes, don't touch me, and bring me some coke.
Okay, the first two make sense, but why the third one?
The Coca-Cola company and their products are very important to me, Sarah. So my first night there, I went to a Tokyo nightclub, and I asked the bartender to bring me some coke. He brought me into the back, and he gave me a brick of cocaine.
Wow.
Yeah, I totally got the translation wrong. Turns out it was a Yakuza-run club.
Wait, like the Japanese mafia. What happened next?
Well, he gave me the whole brick for free. And then I wasn't doing anything else for the rest of the night, so I just hung out with him and his Yakuza friends.
Oh, wait, hold up. Why would a bunch of Yakuza thugs give you free drugs and then just let you hang out with them?
Oh, okay, you don't know. It's like a thing in the Japanese mob for gangsters to get their pinkies cut off. Sorry, he's currently hiding. But when they saw my friendly little stub, they assumed two things. One, that I was in the Yakuza. Two, that I was hard as fuck.
Wow. I mean, that's super educational.
Yeah, and after that, we, like, started hanging out all the time.
Alex, I don't think you can just hang out with Japanese thugs.
Why? They're so cool! Do you see how stylish they were?
Yeah, those are some pretty stylish criminals.
Exactly. And so, we literally started hanging out all the time, and, I didn't know how to tell them to leave me alone. So anytime I wanted alone time, I would just tell them to get me some coke. And then they would leave for a little bit, and every time they came back, they would bring 1 or 2 kilos of cocaine with them.
Holy guacamole, Alex.
Guacamole is right. Before long, my hotel room looked like an igloo. I had so much cocaine. And I didn't know what to do with it, so I started selling it.
Yeah, what else would you do?
And not to brag, but I've been doing really well. We've taken over some new territory. We recently took over and pushed out the Yakuza. Is that Pepsi?
Hi.
Sarabana day.
Alex?
Yeah?
What was that about?
I don't know. It's not. It's fine. They're just playing around.
Okay, but what did you tell them? Where did they take that guy?
I don't know exactly. I just say yes, like every three words, or like three things, and then I just see what happens. If it works for the president, it can work for me.
What was that?
They're just playing around. They're silly guys.
Yeah, I don't really get that vibe. From them at all. Oh, they're back. There's only two of them now. Where's the third guy?
Sindirisu. Hi.
What? Alex, what? Alex, I don't think you know what you're doing. Can somebody call someone, please?
We'll be right back, guys.
Thanks. Thank you so much. So for those of you who don't know, March is National Women's History Month, and we here at Purchase Late Night have the honor of hosting a very, very important guest who will be talking to us today about the women's movement throughout the ages. Phil, what happened to political activist and feminist organizer Gloria Steinem?
Yeah, I don't think she's going to make it out. But don't worry, we've prepared something.
What?
Yeah, me and the boys have cooked something up.
Well, I don't think that's entirely appropriate, Philip.
Oh, it is. First wave feminism begins in America in the late 1840s. In 1848, Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Lucretia Mott led a two-day convention to discuss the social, civil, and religious rights of women. This event is known as the Seneca Falls Convention and revered as the start of women's activism in America.
Second wave feminism began in the 1960s. The movement centered itself around women in the workplace, their reproductive rights, and questioned traditional gender roles. Many individuals that led the movement were members of other activist groups, such as the Black, Asian American, and gay and lesbian civil rights movements of the time. Many of the female supporters of these groups felt as if their voices would not be heard until issues of gender equality were first addressed.
Third wave feminism is the feminist movement of right now. The most notable event of this wave has been the Women's March on Washington and the various sister marches that occurred across the globe the day after Donald Trump's inauguration. Third wave feminism intends to dissolve the division between white feminism and those that qualify as other. It is intersectional and supports women of all ages, socioeconomic backgrounds, races, religions, sexual orientations, and ethnicities. Those who do not support any of the aforementioned are truly not feminists.
Oh, wow, that was incredibly informative.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God. Gloria Steinem, everyone.
They stole my PowerPoint.
Oh, hush, hush, Gloria. Come on. We would never do that.
Okay, wait. What is going on?
They stole my PowerPoint and my speech, and they told me to go to Crossroads. Oh, it's terrible.
Oh, my God. That's awful. I'm so sorry, Ms. Steinem. Philip, what did you do?
All right, fine. You got me. I stole her speech. Whatever. Maybe I forgot where we filmed. Not a big deal.
We're just trying to say we're not the bad guys here. We're feminists.
So, to prove that, you stole a speech and lied to our guest?
We just wanted to show how much we care about the movement.
It's great that you feel that way about the movement, but there are other ways to get involved.
I told you, we should have dressed up like women for this.
No. By all means, break down the gender construct, but sometimes the best way to get involved is to simply listen.
What? Oh, no, I'm kidding. Continue, please.
Who are these people that have just been given this platform to speak on? Let them have a shot. Women have been fighting for their equal rights in this country since 1848, and, you know, it's about due time that we give women the opportunity to speak about their own movement.
Yeah, I think we kind of went about this the wrong way, huh?
I'm sorry, Ms. Steinem.
Yeah, sorry, this one's on us.
Actually, the past 169 years are on you guys.
She said 69.
Well, I think we all learned a lot today.
That's right. And hey, sometimes the best way to get involved isn't by sticking your hands in the pot and making things all messy. Just sit back, relax, and listen.
Gloria Steinem, everyone.
Out of
cast of the BA Main Stage Horror Show.
Yeah.
So will you introduce us and tell us what you do in the show?
I'm Jonathan.
I'm Autumn.
I'm Cole.
We're all actors in the show, but we're also all playwrights and kind of directors of the show as well.
Yeah.
Awesome. So will you tell us what Horror Show is?
Horror Show is a devised piece written completely by our directors and the cast themselves. So everything is raw, everything is new. Like the show that everyone has been seeing or will see this week is all completely fresh and new ideas made by the students. It's awesome.
Yeah. Awesome. What was the process like for you?
It was started off with a lot of just like writing. We took different inspirations. Our theme was trauma. And we took from there and started writing pieces, and then we started putting it on its feet, and then we started taking our writing and like mixing them together until we had this full script that we could then put like on its feet with a full production.
Awesome. And so what is the show about now that you've kind of finished it?
Well, so like there's many like very underlining themes in the show. I mean, it's not about just any one concrete thing, but one main thing that's kind of like underneath the surface, that's like the one consistent thing throughout the show. There's a Slenderman stabbing a few years ago.
Yes, and
with the three girls, and so like the three girls that were a part of the stabbing, Morgan, Anissa, and Peyton, they're seen in the show. There's no direct reference to Slenderman, but there's a lot of like subtle references. It's a very much around like the negative space of that stabbing, and then like trauma as a whole, and like acts of violence, and how like people cope with it. And it's a great, very weird, quirky show.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not completely sure entirely like what it's all about myself, but it's a fun time, and everyone who comes see it will like take something away from it.
Yeah,
for sure.
Okay, that's good.
It is. It's a lot of fun.
And Cole, I've heard that you kind of have a little bad luck with the show, so it's like a little horror show for you.
Yeah. Well, basically, like, during tech week, right, it's very stressful. I'm like under so much stress, like midterms, like got out of a relationship like a month ago, like just like everything, you know, the weight of the world's on my shoulders. And they expect me to like be able to bring my costume to tech. It's kind of unrealistic.
How
you know
dare
I mean?
They?
Yeah, so like the first day of like tech rehearsal, like I left my shirt because, so like I have a plaid shirt and that's my costume, but I also have pajama bottoms that are plaid as well. And my dorm room is a mess because it's like kind of a metaphor for my emotional state, like just clothes everywhere. And so like I put my shirt like on the chair, but I also put my pajama bottoms on the chair. So I grab my pajama bottoms thinking it's my shirt and take it to the rehearsal so I don't have my costume, my shirt. And then they're like, Cole, don't do it again. And then like the next 3 days, like I just left some article of clothing that was a part of my costume in my dorm. And yeah.
Well, hopefully when the show goes out this weekend, you won't be naked on stage. That's what we hope for.
Hopefully, but you never know. It's theater.
Okay, you can see a Horror Show this Thursday through Saturday at the PAC. Student tickets are $5, and the show goes up at 7:30, and there's a matinee, correct?
Yeah.
Yes,
on
Saturday there's
Saturday.
A matinee at 1:30. Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
We say hello.
Shows left, and then I'm going to space.